topic is IUPAC nomenclature. Nomenclature, the name, its meaning is naming an organic compound. That is nomenclature. IUPAC, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, has given certain rules to be followed when we are going to name an organic compound. For example, the compound that you already know, let us take an example of ethanol. That is the structure, you already know, I'm writing the structural formula of ethanol, where the formula is CH3CH2OH. We call this compound as ethanol. What is the reason? How did the name ethanol came for this compound? This is what we are going to study today. So to study this IUPAC nomenclature, we have to know two things. Number one is homologous series. Number two is functional group. What is meant by homologous series? Homologous series are group of organic compounds which possesses a similar in structure and similar chemical properties. To understand this further, let us take an organic compound. For example, let me take methane, the formula CH4. Let me take the second compound, ethane, that is C, and you can see that it has two carbons and it has six hydrogen. So when we are going to compare the structure between methane and ethane, the formula for methane is CH4 and for ethane is C2H6. Now the difference between these two is a group, CH2 group. So homologous series means the elements which has a similar structure, the compound which has a similar structure. For example, the structure of methane and ethane are similar and they have similar chemical properties. The successive compound differ from each other only by a CH2 group. Such compounds are called as homologous series. These two compounds belong to the homologous series called as alkane. So these two compounds, methane and ethane, belong to a homologous series called as an alkane. Let us take this structure already, because we have explained this structure. Let us take one more compound from this, methanol. So when you are going to compare between methanol and ethanol, the difference again is the same CH2 group, and so they have similarity in the structure and also similarity in the chemical properties. Because of this reason, they belong to a homologous series of alcohols. So again, I revise, what is homologous series? Homologous series are a group of organic compounds which possesses similar structure and similar chemical properties, and they differ from each other only by a CH2 group. Now we are going to see what is meant by functional group. Functional group can be an atom. It can be an atom, or it can be a group of atoms arranged in a specific manner which gives chemical properties to the compound. I repeat, a functional group may be an atom, or it may be a group of atoms which is arranged in a specific manner and it gives the characteristic chemical property of a compound. We call it as a functional group. Okay, now let us see with an example. Now, the most common structure we know is, which we usually use, is CH3COOH, which is nothing but the acetic acid. We call it as acetic acid, and it has all the property of an acid. For example, it can combine with a base forming salt and water, pH will be less than 7. All this property of an acid is given by a specific group, that is only COOH group. This group gives this characteristic acidic property to the compound. So this is called as the functional group. So if we know the functional group only, we will be able to write the IUPAC nomenclature. So today we are going to see only the functional groups as per the ICSE board. Now the name, common name or a trivial name is nothing but a general name. For example, acetic acid will be, acetic acid is otherwise the common name. That is why I have given that example. Acetic acid, the name of this compound as per IUPAC name is ethanoic acid. Acetic acid is a common name. Usually the common names are derived from Latin, either from the source from which we get that particular compound, or from any other reason it is given the common name or trivial name, but we are supposed to learn the IUPAC names for the particular compound. So we have to have learned the set of rules. So to know or to make the IUPAC nomenclature more clear, first thing we have to see the functional group. Now I have already defined what a functional group. It may be an atom or a group of atom which is arranged in a specific manner which gives a characteristic chemical property to the compound. So let us see what are the functional group that we are supposed to learn. And if this particular functional group is present, how the name of a compound will end. That is what we have written as suffix there. How the name of a compound will end. R and X. The R denotes here hydrocarbon. R is denoting here hydrocarbon. What is meant by this hydrocarbon? It may be any carbon compound is only denoted by R. So here a carbon, a hydrocarbon chain is attached to a halogen. Halogens may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine are only called as the halogens. So here R and X, that means a hydrocarbon chain is attached to a halogen. And OH means it is alcohol. A hydrocarbon chain is attached to an alcohol. Already we have seen an example for that. For example, it is CH3OH. CH3OH, that is nothing but the methanol. So a hydrocarbon chain is attached to OH. It is alcohol. The suffix will have OL, methanol. Now here it is C double bond OH. It is, if this particular group is attached to a hydrocarbon, the compounds will be called as an aldehyde and the suffix will have al. Al as the suffix in its particular name. And if the particular compound has a group C double bond OH is attached to a hydrocarbon, we call it as carboxylic acid and the name will have oic acid. Now I said ethanoic acid. I think you would have remembered that the name of the acetic acid, I said it as ethanoic acid. Now, if the compound has C double bond O, that is a hydrocarbon is attached to a C double bond O in between, then it is called as a ketone. And ROR dash, that means R dash represents a different hydrocarbon chain, then it is called as an ether. One specific thing that we have to note here is this four a functional group. It might be a halogen, alcohol, aldehyde and an acid. The functional group are attached at the end of the chain, whereas these functional groups, C double bond O that is of ketone and O that is of ether, it is attached in between the carbon hydrocarbon chains only. It will not come in the terminal positions, whereas these functional groups will be attached to the terminal positions of the hydrocarbon. The IUPAC nomenclature of an organic compound will have three parts. The first part is called as the prefix. The second part is called as the root name or the parent name. And the other one is the suffix. Now we have seen the suffix. The suffix will hold the functional group. Now the root word for the particular nomenclature. To know the root word, we have to learn the name of the first homologous series of alkanes. If you are going to learn the name of the alkanes in order, that will help us to remember the root word or the parent word. For example, the CH4 is methane, C2H6 is ethane and C3H8 is the first video. I have already given the formula for the compound CnH2n+2 for alkanes. Suppose let me take N value as 8. So if I am going to take N value as 8, it becomes C8H2. H 2 into 8 plus 2. That becomes C8H. A2s are 16. 16 plus 2, it is 18. So if it is C8, it becomes H18. So you can calculate it using the formula CN H2N plus 2. And we have to know the names in order: methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, octane, nonane, decane. If we know this in order and also the name of the functional group, then only we will be able to write the nomenclature of the compounds. And hence, our work will be to learn this, the functional group given in order, and also the root word, at least of the alkanes. I repeat again: methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, octane, nonane, and decane. Once we know the root word and also the suffix that has to be attached to that, it will be very easy for us to write the IUPAC nomenclature.